star for the unlighted orange and our UVX line. Okay. Negative sign x, y. standard multiple choice. Alright, we're trying to look. This time I threw me in there. Okay. Alright, so I am going to just start taking that derivative and see what happens. So what is the derivative of x? One. Good. Minus, and every time I have a minus, we know we write parentheses. Okay, what am I gonna have to do with the x, y, what are the numbers? There is, what kind of rule going on up here? A chain inside E that is a product, so I'm not doing that work, I'm going to do that work down low. So this part here is chain, right? So I'm going to do my Q down low somewhere. Okay. So Q equals XY, Q prime equals, alright, so that's my red, X, what's my green? Y, X. Alright, so. Derivative of red. One, good. Keep green the same way it is. Addition, keep red, derivative of green. Y, one dy dx, right? Okay, and then we have to do the derivative of the outside function. So your outside function is e to the u. So f prime is du, which when I substitute back in the root of the x. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and write that in this parentheses here. I'm going to drop the 1y, right, so I'm just going to make it y. So y plus x y dx times e to the xy. That was just the derivative of that chunk right there. I'm not done yet. Okay, what's the derivative of dy?
2dy
dx. 2dy dx. Yeah, perfect. Equals. What's the derivative of x squared?
2x.
2x. What's the derivative of negative 3? 2. And I'm being very explicit in the notes. You don't have to write 2. Okay. Alright, before I can simplify this, I need to do a couple of things. Okay? You see how I need to distribute this in from this direction? See how there's negative out here, right, in this direction?
Yeah.
So I'm going to distribute the negative and the e to the xy in all at the same time. How cool is it to be able to handle this? So negative y e to the xy. Negative x e to the xy dy dx. Plus 2 dy dx. Distributing the xy in and a negative sign. Alright, I'm going to go get my colors out again. Anything that does not have a dy dx, I'm going to box in yellow. And then everything that has a dy dx, I'm going to box. Alright, so I'm going to keep my dy dx on the left side. So negative e to the xy dy dx plus 2 dy dx equals, I've got a 2x over there already. How do I move to 1? Subtract it, and how do we move from y to the xy? And again, oh, what did I miss? I thought I had a plus section. This numerator could be in any order. Look at a multiple choice. Okay, because you have to look at a problem. All right, what's my next step? Not yet. I have two terms over here, don't I? Got to take out the dy dx, right? So we've left with negative x. Xy plus 2 equals 2x minus 1 plus y equals e to the x.
Is it very, very ugly and cracked?
No. Alright, you know it?
No, it's
not. Wait. Plugging in for the x. 1/2 divided by dx over. She's just teaching multi-step equations and the student unit today. So I'm quite impressed.
Thank you. I just made the mistake that everybody makes. It's derivative of 9.
looks crazy right now. Okay? All over the green square. We can go back in and track them. So red derivative, red original. Green original, green derivative, green square. Now, the last part is when I do an answer like this, not leave dy dx in there. Do I know what dy dx is equal to?
Yes.
I'm going to put that in for dy dx. So my answer would be y minus x over y squared. That's a good answer. I can maybe go y minus x squared over y squared. I'm sure there's ways to simplify the fractions. I'm not going to mess with that. Okay? Yes. Does that make sense still? You can't leave it as dy dx. Okay. And this is the only implicit second derivative is anything like that. We will not see a third derivative usually implicitly. Okay? That would be a little simple. Alright, now let's move back to the new nets. Okay. There is, look at this next one. This is a very typical AP question. Okay, look at this one with me. It's the last one we gotta do. Okay, so what did they give you to start with? What's this mean? That's the first derivative. Do I have to find the first derivative?
No.
No, I started with the first derivative. So I'm trying to analyze what we have right now. Okay? What do they want me to find?
The second derivative.
The second derivative. Okay? So I really only need to find the, I just need to take the derivative of what I've got. I'm really doing the first derivative of the first derivative, right? Okay, so we're gonna call it second derivative though, because that's what they told us. Okay? Equals, what's the derivative of x squared? 2x. What's the derivative of 3y? 3y dx. Okay, before I can substitute values in, I need to replace my dy dx. What am I putting in for dy dx?
X squared plus 3y.
Because dy dx was equal to x squared plus 3y, so I'm substituting that in. Okay? Now, just like with the other ones, I'm not going to simplify anything. I'm just going to plug in, is it a 2 and a negative 5?
Yes.
Okay. I'm just going to plug in my numbers, okay? Because I'd rather deal with simplify numbers than algebra. So, what is, plus it's a time saver, right? I only have to do it once, simplify it once. Alright, what is b going in for the x?
2.
Okay, plus 3 times 2 squared, what's going in for the y?
Negative 5.
So 2 times 2 is 4 plus, let's see, I've got 4 minus 15. So 4 plus 3 is 4 minus 15.
Negative
11, so 4 minus 33, we get negative. Okay. I will get a worksheet posted up today. You should now be able to really finish yesterday's worksheet, right?
Did you guys work out?